10 o'clock hour, we're going to start the homegoing celebration of our dear mother, Vivian Alexander. I wish somebody would just stand to your feet and give God some praise. The Bible tells us to come before his presence with singing, with healthy kids out of Star Church. It's just simply sing this simple song in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, say yes.
Gracious eternal everlasting God, we come before you right now, God. God, we're giving you praise for a life well served before you today, oh blessed God. We come and say thank you for this woman of God that you placed in our life, oh blessed God. But God, the good she done, oh blessed God, for what she meant to us in our lives, oh blessed God. We pray, God, right now, God, in the name of Jesus, as we give praise and honor and glory unto you, for you being our Lord, our Savior, our God, we thank you today, oh blessed God. God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that you would touch the hearts of the family right now, God, in the name of Jesus. God, right now, we know, God, that you're there, oh blessed God. You said, oh blessed God, I will look unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, oh blessed God. God, we know that we can call upon you in the time of trouble, oh blessed God. We know right now, God, you said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted, oh blessed God. So we say thank you for comforting the family right now, oh blessed God. We say thank you, oh blessed God. For God, we know that you're with them, oh blessed God. We know that you're going to carry them through, oh blessed God. God, we just want to give you praise, oh blessed God. For you're so good today, oh blessed God. We want to give you praise, God, for our sister that made it on in, oh blessed God. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Keep your arms wrapped around this family in thy great name, Jesus. Amen and amen, God.
I will be reading in your hearing St. John 14, verses 1 through 4. And it reads, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way, ye know." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hear, and doer of his word, and may it be comfort in your hearts.
We're going to call now, you may be seated in the presence of God. We're going to call for the directors of Pi to come, that the excavated coals and the family will have their final viewing of our dear mother. praise him tonight. Come on, praise him, family.
To the family of Mother Vivian Alexander. Whereas God in his infinite wisdom and mercy has seen fit to call home Mother Vivian Alexander from this present world. We, the pastor, first lady, and the saints of Greater Northwest Church family, share prayers are with you during your time of sorrow. Mother Vivian Alexander was an outstanding member and supporter of the Greater Northwest Church family, a woman who loved the Lord, her children and grandchildren, and church family. She was a big fan of the pastor, and as she would say, "My pastor goes down today preaching." Yes, sir! She would encourage him through messaging and Facebook. Oh, yes, our Mother Alexander had some social media skills. She would share the word with all she met about how good God is. She loved supporting the young people and sowing. God knows the tears we cry and the sorrow we feel, but he is a load bearer and lifter of our soul. So continue to lean on him and remember to live is Christ and to die is gain. Live to live again to see Mother Alexander, and we will shout and say amen on the other side. May God bless and keep you, your fellow servants, Administrative Assistant Tommy C. Vanover, Pastor Evangelist Vivian Vanover, First Lady, and the Greater Northwest Church family.
Vivian Denise Alexander was born on Sunday, February 10, 1957, in Detroit, Michigan, to her loving mother, Catherine Alexander, and to her doting father, the late Bartholomew Alexander Sr. To this union, she was the first of five children. One brother, Bartholomew Alexander Jr., preceded her in death. Niecy, as she was affectionately called by family and friends, and Viv, by her siblings and very close friends, was raised in Royal Oak Charter Township. Vivian received her early education through Ferndale and Oak Park Public School System. Vivian was baptized and received Christ as her Lord and Savior at early age at the New Mount Vernon Missionary Baptist Church in Ferndale, Michigan. Vivian was gifted academically, a musician, and multi-talented. As a singer, she got her start in the New Mount Vernon Missionary Baptist Choir. Niecy was well known as a power alto along with her sisters, my auntie Bobby and Kathy. Niecy knew music so well, she studied and sung as a vocal shaped note singer traveling the Midwest with the New Mount Vernon singers to many do-re-mi conventions. You would hear sing Niecy as though it was written right into the song. Over the years, Niecy sung many genres of music throughout her life, singing in some of Detroit's best, what's that word? Revered, y'all correct me on. Nightclubs, as a socialist and backup singer. However, it was her love of gospel that brought her back home to sing and praise in the church choir she so loved. An instrument of the Lord, he moved her where he needed her. At last, her farewell performance would be made as a member of the Greater Northwestern Kaji Choir. My mama, as everybody knows, was self-made, okay? Niecy attended Shaw College and Lewis College of Business in Detroit, Michigan, in pursuit of a business degree. Ultimately, her journey led her to be a certified bona fide self-made black entrepreneur in fashion as a clothing designer. If you would wear it, she would make it. Her true passion was absolutely fashion. Niecy was self-taught and very talented seamstress and clothing designer. Niecy had her own label called Vivion, as she would pronounce it, under which she showed her design. She would spend many days and nights sewing nonstop, creating and designing. Highlighting her brand and art, she held numerous fashion shows, which we was in when we was little, okay?
Yes.
We loved it, but, you know, we did it for our mama. Her fashion shows throughout the 80s and was sought after by many for her work. She poured her life into her craft. It was unquestionable that she lived in a house full of fine fabrics and threads everywhere. I know because I cleaned it up a lot. Niecy often sang in the key of sewing machine hums. Niecy was living her best life. In her later years, Niecy was dedicated to her church family, where she loved to sing, praise, and participate in different ministries as church mother. Niecy spent her final days sewing masks by the hundreds to keep people safe from the looming pandemic and helping others by cooking meals for those in need. She was an amazing baker. Niecy loved her family. She was especially in love with and adored her grandchildren, Corey, Asia, and Eric. She was always prepared with good food, treats for her loyal family. When she knew they were coming over, she would be so excited. Them kids was coming over to get them cookies. She was ready. I got to go to the grocery store for my grandbaby's coming over. She loved cooking and baking for them, kept them laughing, and always wanted them near. They loved her just the same. Niecy loved to cook for everybody. Okay, Mama, till we meet again. Early Thursday morning, January 21st of 2021. Niecy asked, "What time is it?" An angel appeared, and with it, an unmistakable voice said, "Vivion, well done, good and faithful servant. It is time to come home." He had prepared a place for her. Vivion Denise Alexander leaves behind to cherish in her amazing life story two loving daughters, Gina LaShane Alexander of Southfield, Michigan, and Nakia Deshaun Alexander of Southfield, Michigan. Three grandchildren, Corey, Asia, and Eric, which happens to belong to me. The eldest of her siblings, Viv, leaves behind Bobby, Rick Hector of Detroit, Michigan, Kathy Wesley Amika of Southfield, Michigan, Edward Sarah Alexander of Chatham, Ontario, Emma Jane Scott of Tyson, what they said, Ontario, Belinda Childs of Chatham, Ontario, Tamika Vernon of London, Ontario, Justin Hawgood, Christine of Chatham, Ontario, Jason Brown, Lee Good of Chatham, Ontario, Vincent Parker of Chatham, Ontario, Sarah Smith, and LaShana Alexander. One sister, Centennia, everybody knows her as Tina Key, and one foster brother, Mr. O'Hara Ross Jr., preceded her in death. Niecy also leaves a host of aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, relatives, and friends.
this time, the program calls for remarks, and we're going to ask that you would limit those remarks to a minute to 2 minutes. We know you got a lot to say, but you can't tell it all in one day. If anybody wants to have a remark at this time, you can come to the podium here. We're going to ask that you would line up over on this side also, if you have remarks at this time.
Denise and I met 40 years ago. She became my seamstress. She made my husband and our wedding attire. I can't give for Denise June of last year when she moved into her apartment. Denise was so excited about coming on our side of town. It was like, wow, you made it. She loved her apartment. When I was coming in, the apartment was this big. You gotta get the bathroom. You gotta, Denise, I know what to do. Just sit down. You're in the way. So after we out of clean, girl, you think you could do a Walmart run? I said, Walmart, Denise? I said, okay. So the first experience with her at Walmart, Denise was at Walmart for 3 hours. I'm like, Denise. So this particular day, I drove the truck so we could load it up. Got her home. I'm like, how's the stuff gonna get up to the sixth floor? She said, we gonna take it up. I said, Denise, uh-uh. So there was a gentleman, Albert, such a sweetheart. He gathered the bags, took them up for us. As we came down, I noticed there were like 6 baskets in this apartment to take the groceries up. I'm like, Denise, we don't get it together. Every time we would hang up the phone, I just talked to her 2 weeks ago. She said she got a COVID shot. I got to go back and finish it up in 2 weeks. I said, okay, Denise. There was this mirror, and I took the mirror home. Denise called me every other day. He threw it the mirror. I was painting it. I said, Denise, I'm done with the mirror. Girl, bring the mirror. Last conversation we had, T.I., the mirror is hanging up, and it is so beautiful. And I'm like, Denise, okay, I'm glad you're happy. Don't forget to water the plants. We bought some plants. So in closing, whenever me and my girlfriend would hang up the phone, he always would say, I love you, girlfriend. She said, Tiana, I love you. And I said, Denise, I love you more. And I just wanted you all to know, that was my girl. Yes. I don't care what and what she did. My girl. I love Denise, y'all.
I too love Niecy. I met her about 15 years ago. She came and she joined our church. I met her through my godbrother, Artie Keys. And she and Artie were a thing. Anyway, Niecy was so full of life. I loved being with her. She was funny. I'd go over her house and we would sit at that table. This is before she moved. We'd sit at the table and we'd laugh and talk and we laughed and we talked and we ate and we drank water, pop, juice. That's what I'm talking about. She was such a wonderful person. She absolutely loved her children and her grandchildren and would speak of them often. However, I got to know Asia, Corey, and the baby for some time now. They were little kids and they grow up to be big ones now. She will be forever missed in my heart. We used to sing in the choir when she joined our church, Friendship Baptist Church. We sang in the choir together, and she and I both were tenors because we had heavy, strong voices. And she used to sit next to me in choir rehearsal, and we laughed in the choir, talked, and then we would go on with the singing. We also sang together in a group that we had called God's Voices, and she was a member of that. I would truly, truly miss her. She was one of a kind. I loved your mother and your grandmother, and I'm going to truly, truly miss her.
We're going to ask that no one else comes up. We're on a time limit here. We know that everyone wants to speak, but we are on a time limit. Can we say praise the Lord? Come on, say praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. First, giving an honor to God, the head of my life, to the pulpit. Amen. To this family, my family, I am Jeffrey Sanders, son of the late James Sanders. And I had to get here to put my arms around my little sisters, Gina and Pooh. Amen. I just thank God for being here to celebrate Niecy's life. Amen. Amen. She was a mother to me. She said, hey, son, she called me, text me, messenger all the time. Hey, son, how you doing? What you doing? Where you at? Because she know I will travel this country. And I thank God for giving me traveling grace. Amen. From Atlanta, Georgia, because he didn't have to let me be here, but he did. He didn't have to let none of us be here,
right,
but
amen.
We did. So we're going to rejoice. This is a celebration, amen. So put your hands together, because anytime you see Lisa, she has a smile on her face. She says, son, how you doing? You serving the Lord? Yes, ma'am, I am. Amen. So I just thank God for her life. She sent me some jackets, some pictures of some jackets. She said, I just made these. What you think about them? I'm still waiting on my jacket. Amen. Amen. I'm still waiting on her to send me my studded blue jean jacket that she made. She would always be sewing. Amen. And I'm a hairstylist by trade. I make custom wigs, and I bought a sewing machine probably about 4 weeks ago. Never took it out the box, and I was going to FaceTime her to ask her to help me thread this machine. Amen. And so now I'm going to ask God to send her in a dream to help me to sew, thread this machine, because I know nothing about sewing, amen. But I just thank God, because he's that kind of God, and he'll do stuff like that, amen.
Right.
So I'm going to miss her. To the family, God bless you. I'm QB, Kathy, Corey, Pooh, Jana, everybody. Keep your head up, put God first. This is not goodbye. We'll see her in the morning, amen.
Amen,
amen. God bless you.
She helped me with my sense of style, my creativity. I'm just going to miss her so much.
How y'all doing?
Good.
I just want to say thank y'all for coming here and celebrating my grandma. And I love my grandma. I know y'all love her too. She was always funny, she always kept us fed, always kept us warm. You know, like, she loved us so, you know, she seen the hole in my pants, she was like, take the pants off, get in here right now, I'm gonna sew them up right now. So, I just want to say thank y'all for coming and blessing her and, you know, just being here for us. So, thank you.
Always bet on me and let me simply be me. is hard, unbelievably hard. Though this is hard, unbelievably hard. I love you, mommy, and I will miss you, dear Gina Mookie. And I wrote, Mama, there aren't enough words to express what you mean to me. I love you through the ups and downs, the happy and sad times, and even when you were never mine, I never stopped loving you. I'm gonna miss you, Mom. You were perfect, you weren't perfect, but you were perfect for me. Until I see you again, I love you, Mama, love for you. My baby Asia Rose. Hey, Grandma Girl, is what she called her. I miss you already. I wish I could call you and talk to you one last time. But since I can, I promise I'll never forget everything you did for me. Love, Asian Girl. And I also want to thank everybody for coming. I know it's limited. And I appreciate all the love that everybody has shown us at this time. It was unexpected, but I feel like my mom is at peace and at ease, and that's what's helping me get through it. And I hope it does the same for you. Thank you.
At this time, I'm going to say something for just 30 seconds, and right after I get finished, we're going to have a special remarks from a family member, her daughter, I believe, Jean Alexander. But I just want to say this about Mother Alexander. She's going to be missed. Mother Alexander was funny. She was funny to me. And I was used to getting out of church, and when I would go over to Greater Northwest and she'll be sitting there, I was used to getting out of church and people would say things to me like, Elder Black, can I speak to you for a moment? Or how you doing, Elder Black? And I would that's the way people would acknowledge me. But not Mother Alexander. She would be like, Daryl! Daryl! Come over here, boy. Come on over here. And I'd be like, huh? She'd be like, sit down. I got to talk to you for a minute. That minute would turn into 30 minutes. But Mother Alexander she was just a Jew. She was so funny. She was so hilarious. And one day we had one of the best conversations, and it popped out that she had known my mother, and she was telling me when I was talking to her, we were just talking about a church that she went to, and I was telling her, I said, oh, yeah, my mother used to go there and visit. She said, who's your mother? I told her what my mother's name was, and she said, oh, I know her. How's your mother doing? And I had to tell her that she died, and she just cried right then, and she said, I loved your mother. I love Mother Alexander, and she is truly going to be missed. Amen.
Get an honor to God. He's the head of my life. If you knew my mother, you knew my mother was something else and everything all at the same time. She had a very big spirit, and she loved everybody. She had her sons, but it was her daughters that were her jewels. My mother was so proud of me and my sister. She called us almost every single day, just checking on you. My mother would call us for every single holiday, whether it was relevant or not. Happy Veterans Day, she would say. But I wanted my mother to be happy in all that she did, in all that she was going to do. And my mother was a very forgiving person that was deep in her to forgive someone. And there was something I was still learning to do. But my mother made it look so graceful and easy because she was a woman of God. You could call on my mother for anything, and if she could do it, she would certainly do it. If she didn't know how, she'll know how tomorrow. If I know nothing else, I know what my mother would want, and I know what she loves. So I'm going to ask Sister Thomas to accompany me on a song. And we're going to let that be both the song for that, and so that the her pastor can get into the word. Because I know one thing, my mother wanted the word brought over her service. And I wouldn't have it any other way. Pray my strength in the Lord as I attempt to sing this song. If you want to know where I'm going, where I'm going soon, if you want to know where I'm going,
soul, and all that's within me, bless his holy. dedication from Sister Gina, the daughter.
Amen.
Kia and Mother, we bless you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Again, I am Pastor Tommy Vanover, and I'm going to, I believe, when you go to homegoings, we're in a time of pandemic and we're on a time schedule. And I just always like to tell the preachers that I'm training, always be prepared your message if you want to prepare it, and you got about 25 minutes, you can deliver it, but don't get shaken if you only got five. Now, because you should be able to do it, what God has given you, and people will receive it. And so, Lord, it's in the name of Jesus that we thank you and we praise you. We lift you up and magnify your holy name. We give you glory on this day because you alone are worthy of all the glory and the praise. And so, God, as I come in a very fleeting moment, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will increase in me. Anoint me once again that I may deliver this word with power and conviction. Hide me behind the cross and let me take no glory. But let me give it all to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. And so we bring the greeting from the Glory to Glory Temple and the Greater Northwest Church. And the Lord had put a thought in my mind, if you would just jot this down, I'm going to have to cut over. But if you go and write down the book of John the 11th chapter, as I was thinking about Mother Alexander, this can't do her justice, but I'll try my best. John 11, you will find these words starting in verse number 21. Then Martha said unto Jesus, Lord, if thou have been here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whosoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to thee. And Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. And Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life, and he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? I'm cutting, it's more, but I'm going to cut there, because as I thought about your daughter, your mother, your auntie, as I pondered her death, as she went to be with the Lord, and I do give honor to everybody that honors do. The Lord dropped in my spirit, simply tell the family that she lived to live again. Why don't you just tell yourself that she lived to live again? Yes. Listen, people of God, from the dead is living in you. We will rise with Christ that live in Christ. And so we may face death all day long. Every day, we're getting closer to death. Death is assured. Death is promised. If the Lord don't come in the resurrection before we go, we're going to go this way by the grave. Yes. And so everybody is appointed once unto man to die. And then after that, the judgment. But since I can't do this justice today, maybe I'll just hit a couple of points. I want you to know that the Apostle Paul even tells us, in Romans, the 8th chapter, he said, for we know all things work together for the good that those who love him and are called according to his purpose. Yeah. We find out, people of God, that it's a truth in the Bible that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Yeah. This is why, people of God, we must believe. We must believe on the name of Jesus. We must pray. And Jesus says to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. Yeah. He that believeth in me, he will live, even though he dies. And whosoever lives and believeth in me shall never die. Yeah. So I came to tell you today that Mother lived so she can live again. Yeah. People of God, you must understand, for those who are in Christ, we live with an ever-increasing corruption of their bodies. Every moment we live, we come closer to dying. Every moment we live, every heartbeat, every pain, every sickness, I came to tell you, every corruption, every sickness of cancer bring us closer to our release, closer to the freedom from sin and, amen, death. So I came to tell somebody today in these couple of minutes that the word of God tells us through the Apostle Paul in Romans 8, 35 and 39. He simply says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ?
Yeah.
Shall tribulation or hardship, persecution or famine,
yeah,
nakedness, danger or sword? Knowing all these things, we are more than what conquerors.
Yes.
Through him that loves us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor neither angels nor demons, neither the things present nor in the future, nor any powers, nor height, nor depth, or anything shall be able to separate us from the love of God.
Yes.
I know Mother Alexander knew these scriptures because I taught her these scriptures and she already knew them. But when she knew that she wasn't afraid of death, because Paul writes over there in 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verse number 55, oh, death, where is your victory?
Yes.
Oh, grave, where is thy sting?
Yes.
The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God.
Oh,
I wish I had a church up in here that understood that death is not a death sentence for those who die in Christ, but death is just the beginning of our life of an eternity with Christ. So I came to tell somebody today that even though your hearts are heavy, I came to tell you today that even though you, amen, cry if you will, Jesus himself wept. But I heard in the scripture that Jesus said he will wipe away all of your tears.
Yeah.
I know that Mother, amen, will live again because she lived to live again. I don't have to make nothing up in my last minute as I take my seat. But I came to tell you that Mother did live to live again. I can hear Mother Alexander as I close saying to us, you can't make me doubt him because I know too much about him. I can hear Mother saying, I live because he lives. And I can hear her ringing these words, that my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. I wish I had somebody to just raise your hand and say, oh, Christ, the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. So in that Thursday morning, you don't have to worry about Mama. You don't have to worry about your daughter, because I'm here to tell you she has received her crown. To be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. That's why I choose to praise him today. I choose to magnify him today. Lift up your hands, all ye gates, and be ye lifted up, and the King of glory shall come in. Who he is, this King of glory. I wish somebody shout, it's the Lord, the Lord high and mighty. Give God some praise. I'm done. It's 11 o'clock. Come on, funeral directors, where are you? Come on, clap your hands as they come. It's 11 o'clock, I'm done. Hallelujah, you can praise him. We can't praise him. We can magnify him. When I think about Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Mother, we'll see you in the morning. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. Come to the Greater Northwest Church or tune in at 11:30 and I'll finish this message. But right now, I gotta go. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you.
Thank you.